today I'm doing a book review of Amelia Fang books. Do you love them?
Amelia Fang and the Barbaric Bell. Amelia Fang and the Unicorn Lords. Amelia Fang and the Memory Thief. Amelia Fang and the Half Moon Holiday. Amelia Fang and the Lost Yeti Treasures. Amelia Fang and the Naughty Catacorns. Amelia and the Trouble with Toads. Amelia's holding her pet Squashy. This is Squashy. This is Amelia. She's a vampire. This is Amelia and the Unicorn Lord. It shows a picture of a Unicorn Lord called Fabio. And he's evil. And the Memory Thief. Amelia catching blue petals. And the blue petals are the memories that transform into flowers onto the forget-me-not field. And this, it looks like Amelia is enjoying her half moon holidays with her friends. And this is Florence, and you can tell that's called the half moon holiday because this is the half moon. Because in the middle you can see it's lighter.
Oh, I'm gonna do a review now. So this is Amelia Fang and the Barbaric Bard.
So it says the characters in it. So Amelia likes Swassy, her real pet pumpkin, tongue twister sandwiches, and she doesn't like spoiled sprouts, or the annual Barbaric Bell, Grimaldi, Reaper, Ton. His likes his scythe, his die phone, dislikes Buffy squished toads, unicorns. And guess what? Florence likes picking in worms on toast.
Worms on toast?
She doesn't like being called a beast. She's a rare breed of yeti. Tundine, he's a spoiled sprout and because he met his mom and he's really upset. He never met his mom. He was only a baby when he met his mom. And Amelia Fang does not like going to her mom and dad's Barbaric Ball. And when the spoiled prince of Nocturnia catches Squashy, Amelia must plan a daring rescue. But things in the kingdom of the dark may not be all as they seem. So it's about Tangine, who stole Amelia's pet Squashy, and she's really upset about that. And she must plan a rescue with Grimaldi and Florence. This is Grimaldi, and this is Florence. And in the other books, you will see that all of them have Amelia, and all the ones have the cases on it that's showing what's about. So this one's a picture of her holding Squashy because it's about Squashy. And the Unicorn Lord one is about a unicorn, and this is the Unicorn Lord Fabio. And this is the Memory Thief, and it shows a picture of her catching one of the blue petals, which are the people's memories. This one, it's a picture of them and the half moon holiday. You can tell that it's called a half moon holiday because the moon looks like it's half. And on this one, I haven't read it, but it looks like they're adventuring into the lost trek to see the lost treasure. And Naughty Catacorns, I think that's about some Naughty Catacorns. These are the catacorns, they look like cats, so, and they're called corns because they might like sweet corn. And that it looks like they're scribbling on Amelia's fang's dress. And Trouble with Toads is here. It looks like Amelia is babysitting a baby and some toads start jumping after the baby. Little spoiled prince Tandine, he stole Amelia's pet Squashy, and Amelia and her friend Florence and Grimaldi. This is Grimaldi and this is Florence, and they are Amelia's friends. So this is Amelia's friend and family. This is Count Defermita, Amelia's dad. This is Count Drake the First, or the Third, I think. Amelia's dad, King.
Randomer. And on this one, it's showing all the things that he did when he grew up. And this is Amelia. She's reading all the details about Tanji. And this is Tanji's mummy made. Tanji is so little because he's sneaking. And this is the mummy made glasses. Tanji's gonna get a friend. Amelia's gonna be his friend. And look what Amelia did to him. She threw a bucket of goblin slime at him and locked him in the door and he was crying. And it said that what happened. So Flora started tasting Tanji. And then this is showing them all. And in the Unicorn Lords, it's about Amelia. And in this book, then Tanjin's friends with Amelia. This is Tanji. This is Tanji. This is Florence in the unicorn costume. This is about a leprechaun. And when they're on their way to the Oral Palace, then they get taken by the unicorn lords and but they escape. They must stop the unicorn lords. And it's about them getting to a glitter old palace to find out Tanji's mom. And in this book, then Tanji's the unicorn lords. I'm a unicorn. I have a horn. This is Tanji. This is Tanji. This is Florence. And this is the moon and the unicorn lords. Lords are evil! Very evil! But little did they know that the unicorn lords were not evil. Instead, in this book, it's Mr. Sublime, their evil teacher, who made them put in a memory affection, so it takes everyone's memory that's really strong. And he's the one that's been evil! He's been watching them. He don't want them to win. And actually, he's not more. He's. So, in this one. So, this is it. So, this is Mr. Sublime. This is Mrs. Sublime. And this is Emma Bus. There. So, and the little boy. And actually. It's not Mr. Sublime, the grown-up who is evil. It's Emil Bus. He grew up and lost his sparkles because he was being really bad. He was being a bully in school. He scribbled on other people's horns, unicorn's horns, and ripped their clothes. Yeah, so he grew up with no sparkle on him. And then he became evil, trying to take everyone's kindness because he wanted a This is my Halloween holidays! I love holidays. Halloween holidays, so I've read half of it already. It's a really good book so far. I'm up to the bit when Ricky and Graham, their new friends, they were the guards for the for Glitter Old Palace. These are them. This is Graham, this is Ricky. I thought it was the other way around. And it says on the blurb is very exciting, it says, it's the school half moon holiday in gloomy Nocturnia, and Amelia is going to spend it with her rainbow troops, Rangers troop, on Sugar Plum Island. But whilst exploring, Amelia and her friends are magically shrunk to the size of bugs. How will they make their big journey to break the fear? The curse when they are also very tiny. So this is her family. Amelia's family. And this is Wolf. Dad. This is when they're getting their boats to go to the boat race. And what happens is when Frankie, she picked a spiky boat. She's evil, Frankie. She's mean. She's the bully in the class. And what happened was she had the spiky bow and she made a big giant hole in Amelia's, and Amelia could not move, but something saved her from winning the I got there first badge. So she got a badge because the water magically just moved her, so she won against everyone. And yeah, so she won, so she got the I got their first badge. And now they have to get all the other badges. So I'll show you the picture where I'm up to. So let me just find the picture of this. So I was a sash. Look, this is what Amelia has, but this is Tangy right now. Look, this is the sashes that they look like. And Tangy's going to find the dinner. And look, the funny chapter. Look, this is the badges. Food for the regime fans, and they need to find food for themselves. And this is really funny. It's Bumble's all right. It has got rude humour in it, but it's funny. His bottom is off. So listen to this bit, it's the funniest bit. Kevin, the Cyclops, set fire to his bottom. That's it. Taking Kevin and his burned bottom to the moonlit water. I'm gonna show you these ones after I've done. So I'm gonna do a review again, and I'm gonna do it about these three now. So I'm halfway through this book. Have a sneak peek at all the pages that I haven't read. I can't watch this video either yet. These are the badges that they need to get. Food that farts badge. Hop up the mountain badge. Food foraging badge. Broke a curse badge. Oh my gosh, I just know what happened. Soon after I read all the books, finish this book, I'll be back. So you'll see me again. Probably in 50 days. Just joking. Probably next week. Because I'm fast at reading books. I'm on the fourth book now. When I get onto the fifth book, I'm going to show you my new bookmark that I get. I have this bookmark. It's a pumpkin. And I have another one upstairs. That's just good what I'm reading because it's ghosts and pumpkins. And pumpkins. I love pumpkins and ghosts. I really wish I met a pumpkin. Oh, and also if I buy a pumpkin, then I might show you it. I might make it my friend forever. Except if I can't get it. Bye! Mango said bye. Bye! You like and subscribe this video.